Hi everyone, in this video we discuss how to explore the data using SAS Enterprise Miner. We have the data set created for our project. In the previous video, we have created the diagram and added the data set to this diagram. Before developing and running a data mining model, we should explore the data. Under Explore tab, SAS Enterprise Miner has the node called Start Explore. Let's drag this node to the diagram and link this node to the data source node. To connect the two nodes, position the mouse pointer over the right edge of the input data source node until the pointer becomes a pencil. With the left mouse button held down, drag the pencil to the left edge of the Start Explore node. Then release the mouse button. An arrow between the two nodes indicates a successful connection. Select the Start Explore node. On the left, you will see the properties panel of this node and default settings. There are two important things you need to pay attention to. You can note that in the data group, it shows the number of observations is 100,000, which is the default value. If you have more than this, you can change this number. Additionally, in the chi-square statistic group, you can see that the default value of interval variables is no. We need to change this to yes in the drop-down menu because we have many interval variables. Basically, chi-square statistics are always computed for categorical variables. Changing the selection for interval variables causes SAS Enterprise Miner to distribute interval variables into 5 by default bins and compute chi-square statistics for the bin variables when you run the node. Now you can run this node. Right-click the Start Explore node and select Run from the resulting menu. Click Yes in the confirmation window that opens. That is how to run a node in SAS Enterprise Miner. You can run the entire model or just up to a certain node. In the window that appears when processing completes, click Results. The Results window appears. The Results window displays the following. We can expand the window to see things more clear. First, a chi-square plot that orders the top 20 variables by the chi-square statistics. Second, a plot that orders the variables by their width in predicting the target variable. Note that in the Start Explore node, SAS Enterprise Miner calculates variable width using the Gini split width statistics that would be generated by building a decision tree of depth 1. Finally, we see the SAS output from the node, which provides all descriptive statistics. For example, for categorical variables, we have the variable role, number of levels, missing values, mode, etc. Down here, for interval variables, we have mean, standard deviation, missing values, mean, max, skewness, and kurtosis values, etc. We can notice that DEM age and GIP average card 36 have a large number of missing values. We can also scroll down and see information of the target variable. There is another way to explore the data. Select the data source, right-click and select Explore. This way presents the descriptive statistics in a different way. First, on the bottom of this window, you will see the actual data with all variables and values. Second, on the upper right corner, you will see sample descriptive statistics of all variables, such as variable name, label, type, percentage of missing values, mean, max, etc. Third, the sample properties window on the upper left corner allows us to plot some graphs. Note that by default, SAT Enterprise Miner uses the top sample method, which fetches the first 2,000 rows of data. Since we have almost 10,000 rows, If we want to use all of them, we need to change the fetch size to maximum. Click apply. Now we can see the fetch row changes to 9686, which is our actual sample size. To plot some charts, click plot. There are many types of charts, but we'll construct some histograms. Select histogram, bar chart style, click next. We can build a histogram for a specific variable. For example, damage, we need to change its role to X. And for response statistic, we select frequency. Click finish. This is the histogram for damage variable. This chart shows 10 bins by default. To increase this, right click and select graph properties and change number of X bins to, for example, 100. Click OK. Now we see the more detailed histogram of this variable. As we noticed before, this variable has many missing values. To show that on the chart, we right click and select graph properties and check the box show missing bin. Click OK. Now on this chart, we can see on the far left a column showing missing values. We can use the same steps for all variables. However, I think this is a time-consuming process if we want to build histograms for all variables. To do that in a more effective way, we can use the Start Explore node again. Select this node. In the Train group on the Properties channel, select the three-dot button next to Variables. This shows all variables in the data, similar to the one we saw when we created the data source. To explore all variables, we just highlight all of them. We'll need to deselect two variables, target B variable, which is excluded from the analysis, and ID variable, and click explore, then click OK on the pop-up window. Now we have histograms of all variables. We still have the sample statistics results, the actual data, and the sample properties window. That is how to explore data using SAS Enterprise Miner. Thank you, and bye now.